The definition of stupidity is taking ignorance one step further. You have basic ignorance of just not knowing something, and that is something that I think we all understand. It's a matter of education. Stupidity, however, is when you confront somebody who believes they know everything, who has a conceited, self-important image of themselves, that they don't need to know anything more because they're already smart enough and they know essentially everything they need to know. So it's the inability to recognize what somebody does not know, or to know what they don't know, which is something I think you run into a lot with anybody in any situation, but certainly in the business world, as people become more successful and their egos grow larger and larger, they either are afraid to admit they don't know something, so they're not going to look for you for additional guidance, or they truly believe they already know everything, in which case they're not going to look for you for additional guidance either.
And you have an etymologic explication of ignorant and stupidity.
Well, to take it back, the title comes from a small line or two from one of the Platonic dialogues, where Socrates is in a discussion, and they differentiate between ignorance and that special type of ignorance called stupidity. And ignorance is, in this case, agnostic or agnosia, which I think you're familiar with the term agnostics, and actually is the root word for, I'm not good at Romanian, but necunoscot or necunoscot, for not knowing. The special type of ignorance that is stupidity comes from the root for mathematics, where matia is to learn, and amatia is essentially the negative, not to learn. And that is what, in ancient Greek, they were referring to, that sort of conceited, self-important, self-imposed ignorance that they call stupidity.